Hey there. Hi. Hi. Hey! Hi, I'm Burke Collins.
And I'm Chris Noring.
Yep. And this is 5 tools for building APIs with GraphQL.
Oh, yes.
Thing number one, you can just use Express and GraphQL together. And I assume when we say that, we mean the GraphQL package from NPM?
Yeah, exactly that. So you can use the NPM package with GraphQL. You could also be using Express, which is what you're going to use together. But you need to hand-roll your schemas, your resolvers, your queries, and your mutations.
Whoa, that sounds a little complicated.
It kind of is.
And that's because?
Main reason is a bit complicated is the fact that you're very close to the metal. You have to do a lot of things yourself, and you're kind of flying blind. You don't see what you're doing.
I'm going to be honest, I'm still pretty confused.
I'm not surprised.
Thing number two, you can use the Express GraphQL package library project. Mm-hmm. What is that?
Yeah, so that's going to help you a bit with your confusion, right? So what it gives you is your ability to not fly blind anymore, and you're not going to be as close to the metal. So what it really gives you is a visual environment for your queries and for your mutations.
Well, that sounds a lot easier.
Yeah, well, I mean, you get a sandbox environment, right? Which is going to make your development experience a lot easier.
I like sandboxes.
If you're really into sandboxes, there's this thing on the web that's called graphqlhub.com. And that's going to give you a lot of very cool APIs like Twitter and GitHub. So you're going to be able to try out your skills with the GraphQL query language.
Thing number three is something called Apollo. Tell us what Apollo is.
So we're not talking about Apollo, the space program, but we're talking about the platform called Apollo. So the platform gives us a lot of cool things when building GraphQL servers, but it also gives us clients. And it gives us a lot of other things like cloud functions. So Apollo is really one big platform and one big solution.
Wow, so it really gives you sort of GraphQL plus all the bells and whistles.
Exactly.
Would you say you're more whistles or more bells? Which one do you like better?
Whistles.
I'm a bells guy myself. Thing number four, Azure Functions. You can use serverless with GraphQL.
Yes, you're very right. So with Apollo, there is this really great support for Azure Functions, which enables you to actually build GraphQL, and you don't have to worry what happens to your query, because this library is going to take care of it, pass it over to Azure Functions, and boom, there you go.
Yeah, you know, Simona and I just made a series of videos on using GraphQL with server functions, which will be in the notes below. And you know, serverless is all the rage.
I've heard that too.
How many blog posts have you written about serverless?
Not that many.
How many?
Exactly. Zero. Exactly zero.
Well, this interview's over. Thing number five, Prisma. Hmm. Now, I have no idea what that is, so this one is all you.
Right. Okay, so Prisma is a bit like comparing it to Apollo. Prisma is a big platform that you use for clients and for servers. But you can also use it to be the middle layer between GraphQL and your databases. Because at the end of the day, the cool thing about GraphQL is the fact that you can ask really deep queries and you don't know how to resolve those. And that's where Prisma sits in the middle and kind of fixes that for you.
So basically, like, you just throw Prisma up there and then GraphQL just sort of like magically appears.
Yeah, it's a lot like magic.
I'm Burke Collins.
I'm Chris Noring.
Yes, you are. And now you know 5 tools that you can use to build APIs with GraphQL.
Indeed.